In this video, we're going to talk about three amazing marketing strategies that Disney uses that you're going to be able to duplicate in your own business. Disney is a master at marketing. If it's not clear to you, they're one of the biggest companies in the world. They're amazing storytellers, and they've built brands around their characters and their stories. And small businesses can take note from what they do and really apply some of these very, very important strategies and see their business grow as well. So let's get into today's video. Hey there, everybody. My name is Brandon Brashears. I create daily digital marketing videos here. So if you're looking to grow your brand or your business with digital marketing, be sure to subscribe. If you like the video, hit that thumbs up button and comment below if you have any questions at all. So let's talk about Disney. Disney is a titan of marketing. They are huge. They've been around for Mickey's almost 100 years old, and Walt Disney has built a tremendous empire. I don't think anybody would argue that. But there's a few things that they do that is extremely, extremely smart that you should be doing, and it's marketing related. So let's talk about it. I think the first thing that they do, number one, is when they develop an asset, they repurpose that asset for all kinds of other things. So I'll give you an example. Let's talk about Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, for example. We have a movie that's seriously almost 100 years old. It was made in like 1936 or something like that. And they have repackaged, repurposed, and resold this through all kinds of different channels. So they took their one asset, which is Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, which isn't even their story. They don't own that story. They took it, they made a story about it, and then they are repackaging it. So they had the initial movie and box office, which did well, and then there's been books, merchandise. They've repackaged and reproduced that video. They did it on VHS, and I'm sure they did it on Laserdisc, and they did it on DVD, and they did it on HD DVD, and they did it on Blu-ray DVD, and 4K DVD. Not just the movie, then you have all of the merchandising, you have clothing, you have costumes, you have stuffed animals, you have all kinds of things. The point is here that they've taken something that is seriously almost 100 years old, and they continue to repackage, repurpose, and resell this asset. They've done this with all of their movie productions, and all of their characters, and their theme parks. They're able to constantly churn out things that look and appear new, but in reality, it's the same thing just being repackaged over and over again and sold in a new way to consumers who like the product. I think that seriously, I probably bought, when I was a kid, I probably had the VHS just in my house, and I'm sure I bought the DVD. I'm sure I've rebought the Blu-ray. I'm sure that I've bought the digital version, right? So like they've resold this. When they have a customer who shows interest in this, there's additional multiple ways for you to buy and engage with this franchise. And it just is extremely smart. So there's also been spin-offs and all kinds of things where they take specific characters and then they'll make, you know, different kinds of merchandise and all kinds of things. The point here is repurposing works. When you have something that is high quality, so whether it's like a piece of content that's a pillar post or a video or some kind of content or a product, you can repackage and repurpose that and reuse it and get so much benefit out of it, especially if it's something that people like and are engaging with. So if you have something that's working or that's something that people like, take that and figure out, how can I repackage this to make this new? What can I add to it? What can I take away from it? What can we do to make this something that somebody would want to buy again? And when you figure that out, you're going to be able to add more revenue to your business, because you're only able to do two things, either reduce costs or increase sales. And that's how you make more money with digital marketing in business. So if you can sell the product more times over time, you're going to make more money. The second thing that Disney does, which I think is tremendously amazing, is that they are amazing segmenters. And what that means is that typically with content and things, what we try to do is we try to use a piece of content to identify what people are interested in. So I'll give you an example. With veterinary practices, you have content that's for cat owners and you have content that's for dog owners, right? Because dog owners are interested in things that are different than cat owners and vice versa. So content is what basically puts these different people into these different buckets. And inside of Disneyland, they do the exact same thing. So for example, if you go into Disneyland, you go on a ride, like let's say Star Tours, when you're done with Star Tours, what happens? You exit the ride, and every single one of the rides exits into a gift shop. And it's not by mistake. You just got hyped up, you waited, you engaged with that piece of content, which is the ride, and now they're showing you relevant offers based on what you expressed interest in. If you don't like Star Wars, you're not going to wait in line for an hour and a half to get on the Star Tours movie, or Star Tours ride, right? You're not going to wait an hour and a half to get on the Splash Mountain ride, or Pirates of the Caribbean, or whatever ride it is. Every single one of these rides has a gift shop with relevant merchandise in it. And so the rides are what are segmenting the different traffic, which is the groups of people, into different areas, and then they're upselling at the end there. So they are tremendously effective at selling merchandise and getting you ready to buy stuff by using the rides as the item that segments. So this is what the end goal is for you and your business. You should be segmenting your content. It should be set up in a way so that if somebody is a dog owner, the content that is going to attract dog owners, you then will show relevant offers to people who are engaging. So content is what segments, and then show offers that are relevant. The more relevant you can get, the more effective you're going to be, because you're creating ads and offers for people that are going to be interested in what it is that you're selling. Now, the third thing that they're amazing at is the customer experience and the customer journey. They are not just selling, you know, like amusement park rides. There's a huge difference between like a premium experience, which is what they're selling, and there's a ton of other theme parks in Southern California. I live in Southern California, so like Disneyland is definitely the higher priced theme park. Right down the street, we have Knott's Berry Farm, which is a good theme park, but they don't sell the same experience. Disneyland has branded themselves the happiest place on earth. It's not just a place to go to ride fun and exciting rides. It's an entire experience. They're selling magic, and they're selling, you know, enjoyment with your kids and the joy that's on your kids' face. Your kids would be very excited to go to Knott's Berry Farm too, but it's not the same as when they're at Disneyland and they're engaging with, you know, the princesses and the castle and all of that stuff that makes the experience seriously magical. Not only that, they have spent a ton of money, energy, and resources into making sure that the experience is perfect. They're able to, in fact, change light bulbs from behind the walls so that the lights are never out on Main Street, right? That's amazing. That's an experience that is unlike any other. And so as a result, because they're selling not just the actual going to a theme park, they're selling the dream and the magic and the emotions that go there along with that. And if you look at Disney's ads, you'll see how amazing they are at selling this idea instead of just selling a theme park. And so, as a result, they're able to charge tremendous prices. Not only that, they raise the prices all the time, and they're still busier than ever. So, if you're looking to set yourself aside or apart from, you know, other businesses that are offering the same thing, how can you increase the customer experience? How can you use that in your marketing to really set yourself apart and set yourself up as the premium option? Maybe you don't want to be the premium, maybe you want to be the affordable option. In that case, you know, figure out how can you market yourself as the affordable option. But I know a lot of people like to be the premium option. They like to do premium prices and experience and things. So if that's you, you need to figure out how can you make it magical. You're not just selling, you know, a fun time, you're selling magic. What can you do to make it magical for your clients and customers? So I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, be sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know what is your favorite part of Disneyland. What is it makes it magical for you, and how could you apply that into your brand or your business? I would love to know. So if you want to grow your business with digital marketing, be sure to subscribe here. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye.